Who among you, just for my curiosity, who among you have been leading your group for more than 5 years? 5 years and above. 5 years. Okay, we have a few. Some of you are less, I'm sure, are less than 5 years. Whom among you, those who are meeting your group for more than 5 years, is it weekly? Weekly, yan. So if you do it weekly, you have been meeting your group for the past 52 weeks, di ba? 52 times 5, that's about 256 or 260 weeks na kayong nagkikita-kita. Do you still delight in meeting them? Do you still enjoy meeting them? Di ba? Now, you see, our ability to develop leaders is dependent on how passionate we are with our group. And that has to do with attitude. I have been meeting my group for the past 13 years, every Friday, 52 weeks every year. Sawan-sawa na ako sa mukha nila. Pero I enjoy fellowshipping with them. You see, one of the essentials of disciple making is our attitude towards disciple making. There are three ways of approaching it. First, between duty and delight. If we look at our discipleship group, our Friday or our meetings as a duty, you will burn out. Yung feeling na, Friday na naman, di ba? Friday na, ano na iyahanda ako, di ba? Lord, di ba? Kunin mo na sila, di ba? Ganyan. But if that is your attitude, what will happen? The desire to develop them will not be there. Why? Because you are so focused in looking for a way to just get through it. But if it is a delight, you look forward to it, you prepare for it, you have a battle plan for the year, then it becomes something of a joy. In our group, we have what we call, ito, this is something that they look forward to every year. We have what we call our fitness plan. Okay? I help them and we work together, we craft our fitness plan in the four essential areas of our life. Okay, our spiritual fitness, our mental fitness, our relational fitness, and our physical fitness. And every year we would prepare things that we need to do to make sure that we are able to develop in those four areas. And ako, ang ginagawa ko, the delight that I have is that my lesson, the lessons that I do, revolves around those four. And I really look forward to meeting with them. Second is it's whether it's obligation or a privilege. Diba? Mahikipagkita na naman ako. Diba? Nasakit na naman ang ulo ko. Nakaplano na yung migraine ko. Diba? Pagdating na ano, diba? Why? Kasi we feel obligated. Kailangan eh. But that is not the way to do it. You have been given the privilege to shape the lives of people. Can you imagine that privilege? Di ba? You have been given the privilege to shape the life of people and to make them the best that they can ever be. To make them feel and understand that God loves them. If it is a burden versus a joy, okay? If it is a burden for you rather than it being joyful, how do you know that it's a burden? Okay? Pagka hinihila ka ng asawa mo para isakay sa kotse, di ba? Sabi mo, ayoko mag-attend ng D-group ngayon. Sige na, attend ka na. Ayoko talaga. Mahikita ko na naman si ano. Hindi, attend ka na. Hindi pa pwede, ayoko. Eh, ikaw ang D-group leader eh. Di ba? That is a burden. Di ba? That's a burden. But if you are joyful, if you enjoy it, di ba? Ako, by the way, everything that we do is based on a decision. I always decide to be excited. I always decide to look forward to the meetings. It fills me up. You know, whenever we interact, when I pray for people, when I hear what's happening in their lives, it brings us a joy. If it is a delight for us and we see it as a privilege and we are filled with joy, we will desire to multiply. And the impact is this. the people under you, as you develop them, will have the same kind of passion. They will have the same kind of love for those under them. Okay? That's how it is. But if they see you dragging your feet towards the meeting, looking at your watch all the time, okay? Lagi kang late. Tapos naghahanap ka ng paraan na umuwi na maaga. Okay? Ikaw pa naman yung leader. Nakakaya, di ba? Maintindihan ko yun kung iba. Pero kung tayong leader, then we will not be able to develop them. Okay? So look at things. Have a delight for your group. See it as a privilege for you. And that fill yourself with joy. Okay? What should be our mindset? We have to be very, very intentional. Okay? We have to be very, very intentional. We have to understand that intentionally or unintentionally, we are modeling a behavior to the people that we are discipling. Intentionally or unintentionally. If we have, kung mareklamo tayo, pansinin nyo, pag mareklamo tayo, yung mga member natin, mareklamo rin. Di ba? Pag joyful tayo, yung grupo natin, joyful. If we are givers, yung group natin become givers. Why? Because we are always modeling behavior. So I would rather that you and I model intentionally. It is planned modeling so that it becomes Christless. So the mindset, okay, is to begin with the end of it view. First, we have to believe it is product before process. In other words, it is developing them, their character. That is more important than the process of discipleship. Example, you do 4 W's, di ba? Magpa 4 W's kayo. And then as you go through the questions, okay, as you go through the questions, suddenly in one of you gets so affected by it that she starts to cry. Alam mo, relate na relate talaga ako dyan. Kanina lang sa bahay, asawa ko, umiiyak na siya. So, nakikinig kayo lahat, ha? Ganun ka. Okay, next point. Di ba? Kasi kailangan natin tapusin to, meron pa tayong 3 W's. Di ba? So, imbis na, nasa 1 W pa lang tayo, 3 pa to. Okay, imbis na, if that means that you are more focused on the process. Diba? The more you are focused on the process, the product that will come out is wrong. They will start to think, you know, this group doesn't really care about me. Diba? So when you talk about product versus process, the more yung 4 W's nyo, kahit na nasa 1/2 W pa lang kayo, if there is this person na nagpo-pour out, and that is the opportunity for you to help, you stop the lesson and focus on the person. Okay? So, clear, product before process. Disciple-making before the process of disciple-making. Purpose before program. Okay? Ano yung purpose nyo for your events? Ano yung purpose nyo for your meetings? Okay? Some of us, ang purpose ng meeting natin, kaya tayo tumataba eh, di ba? Uy, kainan. Diba? You know, in my group, every last Friday of the month is Fellowship Friday. And every last Friday of the month, punong-puno kami. Kasi yung lahat na nag-absent nung first three Friday, andun! Kasi kainan. Diba? So now, what is the purpose? Before you even do anything, understand the purpose. Example, okay, what is your purpose for this meeting? Ano yung character that you want to develop? Okay? If you're discipling disciplers, you start to think, what should be the character of the people that I'm discipling? So everything that you do revolves around building that character. It's not having a program and then it becomes purposeless. Okay? And then objectives before plans. What are your objectives? That's why we always start with our fitness plan. They know that our objective at the end of the year is for them to finish at least 4 books sa mental. I actually require. Okay, kung nasa D group ko kayo, okay, magsasawa kayo magbasa ng libro. I require them to read 4 books a year. Why? Because you are only as good as what you know. And as leaders, if you do not read, at a certain point, paulit-ulit ka. Di ba? Isipin mo na lang, day group leader ka. Yung joke mo, dahil hindi ka nagbabasa, paulit-ulit. Eh, 10 taon na kayo nagkikita. Di ba? Sasabihin mo pa lang, tumatawa na sila. Inuunahan ka na nila. O kaya pagdating pa lang, tatawa na sila. O, ba't kayo tumatawa? Hindi, natatawa kami doon sa joke mo mamaya. Bakit, di ba? Bakit? Kasi wala kang binabasa. Okay, so you have to be able to know your objective. What is your objective for your group? And then you plan out. It's not the other way around. Okay? So our battle cry is every member a discipler. Okay, sa amin, in my part of the country, we up this a notch. It's every member a discipler, every discipler a potential church planter. Okay, why? Because it's in church planting that I have seen people, ordinary people, multiplying extraordinary leaders. It is in that context. Anyway, every member a discipler. That's the desire of the Lord. And how do we empower lay members to serve? Okay? That is our strength as CCF. Okay? Why? Because I believe that God, or CCF believes, God plants us where He wants us to grow. You are in your businesses, in your work, in your position, because that is where God wants you to shine, within the context of your sphere of influence. Our impact on the world is based on how we use our influence and our position or where we are to be able to share the gospel of Christ. That cannot be done by full-time pastors. It has to be done by lay ministers. Okay, it is to bring Christ to the marketplace. Okay? In Cavite, sa area namin, we currently have 13 satellites. We're opening 4 satellites this year and another 5 next year. And all of those, lahat yan, among all the leaders, we only have 2 full-time pastors. Dalawa lang. Ako at saka si Fred. All the rest are led by D group leaders and lay workers, and it works. You know, we have this D group this leader. He works in the bank, okay. But right now his congregation has just hit 600, okay. And they're going to do a 4th worship service, and all of them, lahat ng team na yun, walang full time run. They are all working, and they're all discipling, empowering lay members to serve, okay? And then lay members discipling others, okay? Why? Because you have common interest, di ba? You have common interest. Kaya ako, kahit na ayaw nyo maniwala, totoo to, okay? I never lie in front of the camera, okay? I do triathlons. Okay, I do triathlons. Wala sa itsura. Okay, I don't run, I bounce. Okay, I don't swim, I float. Okay, but I finish it. And I am able to interact with the members of my team. And I get to attract people who bike. You know, I'm now discipling. Every Thursday morning, I ride with some leaders of my team. Mga young leaders, mga young businessmen who are in CCF, who are discipling. So we would ride from Imus all the way to Tagaytay. And then we'll have coffee sa Amadeo. And as we have coffee, I would bring out my Bible verse for the day. Okay, and then I'd give it to them, say, what do you think of this? How does this apply in your life? What are the issues, challenges that you have right now in your businesses? And then we would interact. Kasi yun yung common interest namin. Therefore, kayo, to be effective in discipling, look at the common interest. Okay? And then, disciple them. So, lay members discipling others. Developing the laity for small group leadership. How do we develop them for small group leadership? Okay, again, so what are the discipleship essentials? How do we now bring all of this together? What is the framework that we can use? Ano yung bare minimum to be effective in discipling others? Okay, first, okay, ito yung ating triangle. First is intimacy with God. That is the base. Second is reliance on the Holy Spirit. Third is compelling vision and mission. Fourth is infectious passion. Fifth is deep relationship. Sixth is intentional modeling. And seventh is OJT. Okay? So first, let's start. Intimacy with God, a spirit-filled life or prayer life. Remember that discipleship is ministry. And as a ministry, it is God's ministry. Therefore, to be effective in God's ministry, you have to be so intimate with Him that it is He who is working through you and not you working in the harvest field. Okay? Therefore, kailangan yan. You have to have a deep intimacy with God. You have to remain connected with Him. You have to trust Him. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your strength, with all your heart, with all your souls, and with all your strength. Okay? Kailangan yan. Because He is the only one who can fill you. Have you ever felt burned out in your small groups? Diba? And normally, the feeling of burnout happens when you have been so busy, you have not done your quiet time, you have not done your prayer time, you are so focused in preparing the methodologies that you forget to stay connected with God. You see, that's ako na experience ko yan. Every time I don't find the time to do my quiet time, I feel so disconnected with the Lord. Parang very dry. And I don't like to see other Christians. Ayoko makita yung grupo ko. Why? Because it becomes a burden. So intimacy with God is essential. Okay? Intimacy with God results in a transformation of the heart. Transformation of the heart results in trusting the God, and trusting God results in complete obedience to Him. Okay? It all boils down to intimacy. In Acts chapter 6, verse 4, it says, "But we will devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." Okay? We all know this. When we work, we work. When we pray, God works. Even in ministry. Okay? Lalo na in ministry. Only God can change that. Nagkaroon na ba kayo ng feeling na, you know, do you have EGRs in your group? Yes. Lalakas ng boses, di ba? Lahat tayo. Di ba? Ano, yung EGR, yung feeling mo na, have you ever had someone, kasi ito, experience ko to, love na love ko itong taon to, you know, you would text them, they do not reply. Di ba? Parang wala ka, invisible, di ba? And then, they will arrive late. Pagdating pa, maingay, uy, sorry yan ako, ang traffic, nasa gitna na kayo ng meeting, 30 minutes na. Yeah. Arrives late, maingay pa, babagsak pa yung bag, boom, di ba? Ay, pagod na pagod ako. Di ba? Disturbed. Anong ba lesson natin? Anong pinag-uusapan natin? So, kikwento nyo. Di ba? And habang nagle-lesson ka, maingay siya, kinikwentuhan niya yung katabi, ang ganda ng bag mo ah. Di ba? Prada ba yan? Prada? Di ba? Tapos maya-maya, bago pa matapos, biglang tatayo, ay, late na ako, pwede ba ako mauna na sa inyo? Bye! Di ba? Ito yung mga tipong, Lord, kung ayaw mo siyang kunin, ilipat mo siya ng D group. Yeah? Ito yung taong, when you meet a D group leader, sasabihin mo sa kanya, pare, meron akong high potential, pasa ko sa'yo. Yung tipo. Okay, so ito yung mga yun. But here's the thing. If you pray for that person, God will change his heart. Okay? God will change his heart. So, when we work, we work. When we pray, God works. Second, you have to rely on the Holy Spirit. You cannot do this on your own. Okay, you cannot do this on your own. The Holy Spirit has to fill you. Before you even go to your small group, even before you decide to choose somebody that you'll disciple, you have to pray about this. Pray about your lesson. Allow the Holy Spirit to fill you. Allow the Holy Spirit to guide you, even your words. Why? Because He has been sent to us to be our counselor, to guide us, to seal us. Okay? And the work of the Lord can only be fulfilled by the Spirit of the Lord. Okay? And it will also help you in determining the gifts. Pray as you meet your D group, your members, your disciple, the people that you disciple, pray that God will reveal to you the gifting that they have, so that you may be able to use them mightily in the work of the Lord. Okay? What are the symptoms of self-reliance? Okay, first, yung feeling na I cannot do it. I cannot do it. That task is too big. Second is prayerlessness. When you go into your meeting without even praying about it. Third, which is most common, is burnout. You don't want to go to your small groups. You don't want to disciple anymore. Loss of first love. Everything becomes mechanical. Diba? Everything becomes mechanical. Relationship problems. Irritability. Okay? Irritability. Nakakainis na nga yung dinidisciple mo, may inis ka pa. Diba? So no, yan yung mga bagay. And six is worry or fear. Fear of failing. Worrying that you have not prepared well. Worrying about what people will say about you. Okay? No vision from God. No clear vision as to where you will bring your group. And finally, number eight is fear of failure. And finally, you give up so easily. Okay, these are the symptoms of self-reliance. That means that the Holy Spirit is not working in you, or you are quenching the Holy Spirit and you are working on your own. If you start to have these symptoms, come before the Lord, repent, ask for forgiveness, repent, and then ask for the Holy Spirit to infill you, to guide you. Okay? Self-sufficiency, from self-sufficiency to God's sufficiency, means that we are not manufacturers, but we are the distributors of God's blessing. Okay? What exactly does it mean? God, the message that we have is the message of God. In other words, it is not something that we have created. It is God who has given us that message. And it is the perfect message. It is the message about the salvation that we have from the Lord and how it transforms lives. That's why it says that we are simply branches. Okay? If we are cut off from the branch, we are not only useless, we are dead to the ministry of God. Ang example ko dyan is yung rose. You know, I grew up in Baguio. Well, hindi talaga ako nag-grow up kasi maliit pa rin ako. I grew old in Baguio. Okay? I grew old in Baguio. And Baguio, in Baguio, pag Valentine's, I buy rose for my girlfriend who is now my wife. Okay? Piso lang noon, panahon namin. Okay? Piso lang. And I would choose the best rose. And makikita mo yun, meron nakaplug sa ilalim na tubig. It looks wonderful, it looks vibrant. And when I give it to my... But no matter what we do, no matter how much we cut the branch, it dies off anyway. Why? Because from the moment it was taken out of the rose bush, it was already dead. We were just prolonging its life. It is the same. If we are not connected to the Lord, we are already dead in ministry. We may look alive, we may smell alive, but we're actually dead in ministry. Okay, so we have to remain connected. He is the manufacturer. Jesus is the vine. Okay, we are the channel of God's blessing towards those you are discipling. We are distributors and not manufacturers. We simply distribute the blessing of God. Therefore, we are to be dependent on God for our ministry. Okay? Okay, so let's do this. Can we have, let's say, 10 minutes? Okay, so that we can work on this. So group yourselves, discuss this among yourselves. Number one, describe the current state of your prayer life and personal quiet time with God. In what specific way is your current state reflected in the way you lead your D group? And second, among the five philosophies of training, which one do you already practice? And which ones do you need to start practicing in your D group?